हेलो एवरीवन, टुडे वी विल लर्न सब्जेक्ट मैप स्टैंडर्ड 5, रिवीजन ऑफ चैप्टर 1 एंड चैप्टर 2 फॉर टेस्ट पेपर। इन अर्लियर वीडियोस वी हैव लर्न डिफरेंट टॉपिक्स। द नेम ऑफ टॉपिक्स आर नंबरिंग सिस्टम, एंगल एंड टाइप्स ऑफ एंगल, यूजेस ऑफ प्रोटेक्टर एंड वर्ड प्रॉब्लम। Now let's start first point, numbering system. Numbering system is divided into two parts, Indian numbering system or Hindu Arabic numbering system, and second one is international numbering system. Place value according to Indian numbering system. You can see in the slide the place value of numbers: unit place, 10 place, 100 place, 1000 place, 10,000 place, lakh, 10 lakh, crore and 10 crore. In Indian numbering system, commas play an important role to read and write a number. Once again, in Indian numbering system, commas play an important role to read and write a number. You can see here commas are placed after 3 digit, then after 2 digit. Means in Indian numbering system, commas pattern is after 3 digit, then after 2 digit it will come. So this will help us to read a number. First of all, let's start of reading a number. You can see the 21 number. So 21 crore, then after 25 lakh, 21,321. See, it's easy. Let's read again. 21 crores, 25 lakh, 21,321. Now let's see for the international numbering system. The place value according to international numbering systems, their units are given like this: unit place, 10 place, 100 place, 1000 place, 10,000 place, 100,000 place, million, 10 million and 100 million. In Indian numbering system, in Indian numbering system 100,000 was not there. In place of 100,000 there was lakh. So how to read international numbering system? Let's see. Here also comma play an important role to read a number. You can see in this number, commas are placed after every 3 digit. Means in international numbering system, commas are after every 3 digit. So let's read how to read a number. You can see the number 215. So 215 million, then after 254,258. Let's read again. 215,254,258. Now angles and their types. Which are the types of angle? Acute angle, obtuse angle, reflex angle, complete angle, right angle and straight angle. Let's see one by one all the angles. First one is acute angle. What is the definition of an acute angle? An angle which is measured less than 90 degrees is called acute angle. An angle which is measured less than 90 degree, less than 90 degree. You can see here an angle MON whose angle degree is 60. 60 is less than 90. So this angle is called acute angle. Here one more example is there for acute angle, that is 30 degree. Let's see for next, right angle. An angle which is measured 90 degree is called right angle. Exactly 90 degree is called right angle. You can see here letter L. So we have learned in earlier videos that whenever we get letter L, that is called right angle. Next, obtuse angle. What is the definition of obtuse angle? An angle which is measured more than 90 degree and less than 180 degree is called obtuse angle. Once again, an angle which is measured more than 90 degree and less than 180 degree is called obtuse angle. Here you can see an angle which is greater than 90 degree. You can see here 90 degree, it is greater than 90 degree. It means it is obtuse angle. Here are examples of obtuse angle you can observe in the video. Now next is straight angle. Straight angle means straight line. An angle which is measured 180 degree is called straight angle. 180 degree is called straight angle. Next is reflex angle. An angle which is measured more than 180. More than 180 and less than 360 degree is called reflex angle. You can see here in the picture that angle which is greater than 180 but less than 360. An angle which is measured more than 180 and less than 360 is called reflex angle. Here examples are there, you can observe it. Next, complete angle. An angle which is measured 360 degrees is called complete angle. Complete angle means whole circle. A circle having 360 degree. An angle which is measured 360 degrees is called complete angle. Now in identifying following angles, you will see, you will get a question like this in a test paper. You have to mention their angles. Here you can see 90 degree means which angle? Right angle. 110 degree, it is greater than 90 and less than 180, so it is obtuse angle. Same way 154, obtuse angle. 68 degree, less than 90 degree means it is acute angle. 45 degree, less than 90 degree, so it is acute angle. 250, greater than 180 and less than 360 means it is reflex angle. 180 degree means it is a straight angle. Now, next question is, draw the following angles with the help of protractor. We will use in this this angle to measure angle. We will use here protractor to measure angle. We will see a video for that. How to use protractor to draw an angle. We require protractor to draw an angle. Now you can see here in protractor, scales are given, two scales are given, inner scale and outer scale, and a center point of a protractor. So how to draw an angle with the help of protractor we will learn. First of all, we will draw a line. This is a center point. Now two things you have to keep in mind. Two things you have to keep in mind to draw an angle. First of all, you can see this line, blue line on protractor. This line you have to put on this red line. You have to cover this line on this red line. Means protractor, blue line, you have to cover this line. Means it should be come under it. And the center point of this line, you have to, this line and the center point of protractor, you have to keep it on this. So let's see once again, which are the two things you have to keep in mind. The line of protractor must be covered on this line, and the center point of protractor must be upon upper side of that point. So let's see how. You can see the center point and the line is covered. Now as we know, zero start from this side, means we have to see inner angle. You can see here zero. Now from zero we have to read the numbers 0 10 20 30 40 50 60 70 80 90. Suppose we are measuring 90 degrees, so we will mark here a point on 90 degrees, and then after we will join the two dots. So now we will name the angle. Angle A, B, C, and the angle form is called 90 degrees. So we can write angle as measure angle ए बी सी इज इक्वल टू 90 डिग्री. वंस अगेन व्हाट यू हैव टू डू, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल द लाइन ऑफ प्रोटेक्टर मस्ट बी ऑन द लाइन ऑफ द लाइन विच यू हैव ड्रॉन लाइक दिस. एंड देन द सेंटर पॉइंट ऑफ प्रोटेक्टर मस्ट बी ऑन द this on this point. This point is called vertex of an angle, means on that particular point like this. Now you can see in the video that you can see the exactly 90 degree or L letter. By this way you can measure different angle. Let's measure one more angle. This is the angle we have find 90 degree. Now B number 45 degree. So what the things you have to remember? First of all, draw a line, mark a vertex, put your protractor on that particular point, and the line must be under that line of protractor. Now we are measuring here 45 degree. So we have to see inner degree means 0, start from here, 0, 10, 20, 30, 40 and 50. 45 come in between 50 and 40 means here. So when we join these two dots, we get 45 degree. We will name them X, Y, Z. And the angle form is called 45 degree. So measure angle X, Y, Z is equal to 45 degree. We solve one problem. First question is, a log board goes 6 km in 1 hour. Means here speed of the boat is given 6 km per hour. Now question is like this, how long it will take to go 24 km? Means in this question distance is given. Distance is equals to 24 km. Now we know the speed of the boat is given, that is 1 hour is equals to 6 km. Now in question 24 km is given. 24 km is given. We have to find a time. What is time that we have to find in hours? Okay. So in this question, what we have to do? We have to do division. 1 multiply by 24. 1 multiply by 24 upon 6. Now in 6 table we know, when 24 comes, 6 1 is 6, 6 2 is 12, 6 3 is 8, 6 4 is 24, so 4. So our answer is 4 hour. So what is the answer? It will take 4 hours to go 24 kilometer. Question number B. How long it will take to go 84 km? 84 km. Here distance is given 84 km. We know the speed of the boat, that is 1 hour equals to 6 km. 1 hour is equal to 6 km. In the question what is given? 84 km. Means we have to find how much hour it will take. Means in this sum also we are going to do division sum. 1 multiply by 84 divide by 6. Now in 6 table when 84 come, so we can say, if you want to say directly, if you know the table, 14 6 is equals to 84. 14 6 are 84. So answer is 14 hours. So it will take 14 hours to go 84 kilometer. Now word problem number 2. Maria said Anna bus fees for rupees 80 per kg. Means here 1 kg price is equal to rupees 80. So now two questions we will solve. First question is, how much does she earn for 7.5 kg of anna bus? Means we have to find price of 7.5 kg of analogous fish. What is given in the question? 1 kg is equals to rupees 80. So 7.5 kg is equals to how many rupees? Here we are finding for more, so that's why we will do multiplication. So 7 multiplied by 80 plus half multiplied by 80. 7 is 56 and this is 0 will add. So rupees 560 plus 8 in 2 table when here means 2 4s are 8. So we can cut this as a 2 4s are, so 40, 41s are 40. So our answer is rupees 40. So now 560 plus 40, that is 0 plus 0, 0, 4 plus 6, 10, means 0, 1 carry, so 6. So answer is 600. So the price of 7.5 kg of anabas is 6 rupees 600. Now question number B. Priyanka pays rupees 240 for anabas fish. How much does she get? Means in this question you have to find how much fish she will buy for rupees 240. What is given in the question? What she pays? She pays how much rupees? Rupees 240. And we already know that price of anabas fish 1 kg equals to rupees 80. Now in this question how we will solve? So let's see. Rupees 80 is equals to 1 kg. Rupees 80 equals to 1 kg fish. Okay? Anabas fish. So for rupees 240 is equals to how many kg? Means in this also we have to do division sum. 1 multiplied by 240 is equals to, so we multiply 1 by 140. 1 multiplied by 240 divided by 80. Let's cut 0, 0. Now in 8 table when 24 come? 8 1s are 8, 8 2s are 16, 8 3s are 24. So 3 will come. So 1 3s are 3. So answer is 3 kg. So she will buy 3 kg and I was fish.